Hey, Iceland. How are you? I'm Dexter Charming.
Oh, hi, Dexter.
How is your head? You seem to hit the ground pretty hard on Hex Vision.
I really don't want to relive the most epically embarrassing moment of my life, if you don't mind.
Oh, of course not. But I've had worse moments myself, honestly.
Was there something you wanted?
No.
Okay then, it was nice to meet you. I'm just gonna go now.
Oh, wait.
Yes?
Would you maybe like to catch a movie sometime? Like, this weekend?
A movie?
Yes, at the Multihex.
We wouldn't have to talk much, right?
Haha, right.
Because I'm not that good at making conversation, and I can tell you aren't either.
You're very perceptive.
Okay, well, in that case, sure.
Grimtastic. I'll swing by after tea time on Friday, okay?
Sounds good.
Wow, she said yes. Oh, hey, Raven! I didn't see you standing there.
Dexter, did you just ask out Iceland?
Well, I kind of felt bad for her. It must be hard to be the next Snow White so unexpectedly and all. So I figured I would just be a friendly face.
A friendly face? By asking her out to the movies?
Well, I mean, yeah, I guess so. You could say that.
I'm going to leave now, Dex. Before I go all evil queen and cast some hex on you and this whole school that I'll regret later.
Raven, wait. I hate my father. I hate him. I hate him. I hate him.
The strangest thing just happened.
Ooh, tell me.
This boy, Dexter Charming, just asked me out to the movies for this Friday.
Well, the word's gotten out that you're the next Snow White, right? Let the jockeying for position begin.
Knock, knock.
Hi, Apple.
Sorry to interrupt, but we were supposed to start Fairytale boot camp today.
Well, I guess that's my cue to leave. Have fun, Iceland.
She doesn't like me, does she?
She just needs time to get used to you, that's all.
So, when you become Queen of Ever After, you'll want every household to have one of these magic mirrors, not just the noble ones.
Why?
So that everyone can communicate. If there's a dragon making mischief in their village, people need to know.
Oh, okay.
Also, I think the mirrors can be a source of revenue for the kingdom.
What do you mean?
Right now, most people travel on horseback, or if they're very rich, by horse-drawn carriage.
Or if they live a very simple life like my family does, they walk.
The magic mirrors can be like portals. I got this idea when the evil queen escaped from her mirror prison. It made me realize she could just step through any mirror and emerge from it. If you built a network of magic mirrors, you could have anyone in the kingdom visit anyone instantly.
Like, you could walk into a magic mirror at your house and walk out of a magic mirror somewhere else across the realm?
Exactly! And you could charge for each trip. And this way, you could generate income forever after without having to raise taxes on your people.
What would you do with all that money?
For one thing, we could make tuition at Ever After High free for all fairy tales.
That's a wonderful goal. You're good at this, Apple. You have a vision.
Yes. It's the one thing I actually do have, but it doesn't matter anymore.
So, I'm afraid to ask, but how are you feeling about all this?
All this? Do you mean the switcheroo?
Yes, I mean, you must be so mad and so scared.
I am both mad and scared. I didn't even know I could be both at the same time.
Me neither, but I definitely feel both as well.
But why are you mad? Isn't this a big step up for you?
Well, not from my point of view. I was trained to live a simple life in the woods and to be BFFAs with my future fairy tale sister, who I thought was my cousin, Rosalind Rhett.
Oh, I see. It's been you and Rosalind your whole life, and now you're being ripped apart.
Yes, and that's why I'm mad. But I'm also scared because, well, I don't know if I'll be a good ruler. What if I mess all this up? I haven't had your training, and I sure as heck don't have your vision.
That's kind of you to say, but truly, it really is just thinking about how to bring out the best in people to serve the kingdom as a whole.
Easier said than done, Apple.
Well, how about me? I'm mad that I got demoted to a forest peasant. No offense, of course.
None taken, of course.
And I'm scared because I have no idea how to survive for even an hour in the woods, let alone my whole life.
Well, since we've had our kingdom management lesson for the day, would you like to learn about forest survival?
I don't know. I think I'm going to royally suck at it.
Come on, the fresh air will do you good.
I don't think I've been past this bridge before.
The bridge is where the fun starts.
If you say so. It's so pretty. Do you guys come out here a lot?
We've only recently come to Ever After High. But yes, Rosalind and I love to spend our days here.
Spend all day? What do you eat?
We forage.
Forage for what? All I see are a bunch of pine cones.
Pine cones contain pine nuts. You just roast them over a fire and they fall out.
Like this one?
That one's already opened and all the nuts are gone. This one's better. See how it's still closed?
Is that what we're eating tonight? I can't wait.
See this bend in the river?
Yeah.
It's the best place to catch fish.
Iceland, there you are. Look, I've got dinner for us. Wait, why'd you bring her?
Rosalind, we're doing Fairytale boot camp.
Did you actually catch that... Don't recognize a trout when you see one?
Apple, catching fish is another skill you're going to need to learn. Now, let's go pick some wild fennel to go with that fish.
Iceland, Rosalind, is this fennel?
Apple, drop it. That's poison hemlock.
Ah!
It's okay.
Fennel usually has yellow flowers on top.
And all parts of fennel smell like licorice.
Did you say poison hemlock? Do you mean I could have killed us all? That would be a yes.
Don't worry, Apple. You'll learn.
Oh, I'm never going to get the hang of this, am I? That's the first time you've said anything I agree with.
Rosalind, be nice. Now let's get a fire started so we can cook that yummy fish you caught and season it with this fennel I found.
This is amazing. I had no idea fish and fennel went so well together.
See, Apple? There are some benefits to living a simple life, right?
So you're teaching me to fish tomorrow?
That's going to have to be Rosalind, because I have to study up on kingdom management.
Oh, yay. Can't wait. Apple, I caught it. Come on, get the net and grab the fish. Okay, I can do this. Whoa! Apple? Apple, you have to learn to get used to bears.
No, thank you.
Apple, a bear is literally a central part of our fairy tale.
No.
Apple, I want you to go approach that bear right now.
Hex no. I'm out of here.
Urgh.
What are we doing?
Shh. I'm trying to show you what the forest animals do when they think no one's looking.
Oh, I think he heard us.
Shh. Be really quiet and still.
Wow, Rosalind, I had no idea how peaceful it could be out here. Just look at all those stars.
That's Orion the Hunter. See his belt?
I think so.
And there's Cassiopeia on her throne.
Where? Is that the one that looks like a giant W?
Well, yeah, you have to use your imagination.
I don't see the North Star. Where is it?
You mean Polaris? It's that one.
Huh. I don't see it.
Well, can't say I'm surprised.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Just forget I said anything.
Rosalind,
You've been snarky and mean to me since you've met me. I want to know what you think is so wrong with me. You want to know why you can't see the North Star? Because the North Star is a metaphor for one's guiding principles, one's core values, and you don't have any. Yes, I do. You care so much about what others think of you that you've completely lost yourself. That's not true. You're just a hollow shell of a fairy tale, always looking for approval from others, from your mother, from your classmates, more popularity, more fame, more legacy, more, more, more. You're completely wrong about me. Am I? Then why can't you recognize a good thing when it's right in front of your face? Well, what do you mean? You're Snow White in Snow White and Rose Red. It's a great story. It deserves your full attention and devotion. Instead, you're running around saying to others that you wish you were in a better fairy tale.
Well, I...
That's what I thought. Good night.